saw this outfit on Instagram last night. Have nowhere to wear it. Gonna still try to make it because I can't help myself. That's right, you guys. Today I'm getting back to my roots. I am hacking a red carpet look. I'm very excited. Well, technically there was no red carpet. It's still virtual. I think Kaley Cuoco was like in her backyard by her pool or something, but whatever. This is neither here nor there. Today on the DIY Designer, I am showing you guys how to hack this Dolce & Gabbana crystal studded tuxedo cropped matching shirt. Amazing situation. And it's a no-so DIY. If you are thinking, Orly, why? You have nowhere to wear this. We don't go anywhere anymore. Things are not happening. I feel you. And that's exactly what I thought when I first posted it. And then my mama texted me and said, if you build it, they will come. She's like, if you design it, you'll end up with somewhere to wear it. And I thought, you know what? Yeah, we should make something fabulous and it will bring the opportunity to wear it into our lives. So that's what we're doing today. Now, this video would not be happening if it were not for my friends at Skillshare. You know, I love them so much and they are sponsoring today's video. And if you don't know what Skillshare is, it is an online community where millions of creatives come together to either learn a brand new skill or maybe like deepen a skill in something they want to become an expert in. And the reason I love it so much is when you have that premium membership, by the way, the first 1,000 of you and only the first 1,000 to click the link will get a free trial of premium. But when you have that premium membership, you can bounce around and take any random class that piques your interest. You could wake up wanting to learn about flowers, wake up wanting to learn how to edit, writing a book proposal, starting a podcast, Photoshop, interior design, painting, journaling, literally whatever, and you could just bounce around and get your creative juices flowing. I think this is the perfect resource right now while we are still stuck at home to really maybe come out of this with like a brand new skill that you could turn into a new career or a side hustle or just something that gives you joy. So if you guys have been thinking about trying out Skillshare, do it now. Click the link below. Again, the first 1,000 of you that click it will get that free trial so you can bounce around and see if it's your vibe. And if you miss it, I hope you don't, but if you miss it, it is still under $10 a month for premium. So that means that all those classes you want to take as full-time or part-time as you want to do it, you can do for under $10 a month, which is just so cool. So I hope you guys will give that a shot. I really appreciate them for supporting this channel. It allows me to do really awesome videos like this that I can share with you, which it's time we get into. So I'm going to shut up and let's get started. All right, step one, I hit up my local thrift store. This is the Valley Value Thrift. I love it. To see if I could find a tuxedo jacket. And I couldn't believe it, but I found this bad boy. It has those exaggerated collars, which is perfect. So next, I went downtown and visited my bestie, Benjamin. He got up on the ladder, looked for trims that would work for me, and handed one by one until I had a tray of goodies that I thought I could put together. On my way home, I had to drive by the Hotel Cecil. Are you guys watching this show on Netflix about Elisa Lam? The girl from Canada who disappeared, and then they found her. Okay, well, I don't want to tell you anything, but here is the hotel. It's extra creepy in person. Look at those weird, creepy shafts. Oh, you guys, it's so weird. And then this Stay on Main, which is a load of horse crap. Oh my God.
I want to go in that elevator. What's wrong with me? I want to go in that elevator. And I want to do everything.
Okay, enough of that. So first thing I need to do is just shorten or crop the jacket. You can do this however you want based off your jacket, but I found it easiest to put it on my dress form and just sort of pin the entire thing into itself. But basically, I just cropped it to the height I want, and you'll do that for yourself if need be. All right, so all of the trims that I bought are connected with like this metal mesh that's cuttable all across the back. So I have the option of either using the trims in their entirety or cutting them to length or even cutting them into smaller tiny pieces. I figured this one length works really well for the center of my jacket, so I cut two identical pieces, so I have one for the right and one for the left. And everything you're seeing me doing right now is just laying it out. There is no glue yet. I'm just starting to figure out the design. Here, these little curved guys are really cool, and they're part of a trim that you can see on the left right there. They actually face each other, which wasn't great because it created a bunch of gaps. So by cutting them and using them as tiny little individual like crystal brooches, it gave me the option to really fit them in like puzzle pieces. Same with these little guys. Those were what I planned on using for my buttons for the shirt, but I bought more than I needed. So I cut a bunch of them apart, and they're perfect little, like they fit. Again, it's really like a jigsaw puzzle. You're gonna be laying out the trims in their entirety wherever possible, and then you're gonna be doing the other ones and kind of fitting it in like a puzzle. Everything I've done so far has been without glue. It's just letting me starting to get a sense of whether this fits, what should go where, and you can almost design the entire thing that way without doing any glue. Then, once you know what one side's gonna look like, you can actually start adding glue to the other side because your right side is like a frame of reference. So for this version, what I did was add glue to all of these pieces first and leave them off to the side, and then one by one add them on. You can see how cool this looks like just as is. You could stop here and just have this kind of a look, but obviously I'm doing the Dolce look, so I'm like really going for it. All right, here are those little floral buttons. Again, perfect little size, nice and small. You add glue to the mesh on the back, kind of just slide them in and push them, get everything as tight as possible so that it looks as crystal encrusted as possible and you don't have huge gaps. Here is that one long length that I did on the other side as well. I laid it down flat, I added one long line of E6000 glue all the way across the back, and then I lay it down as one piece. Now, none of this is glued yet, but do you see this corner, how sharp her corners are? I wanna create that kind of vibe. So I cut a couple different pieces of trim until I figured out which pieces would work together to create that sharp corner. This again is gonna be super specific to the trim that you buy and the blazer that you have and the shape, but really what you wanna think about is making sure that you have enough pieces so that you've got a lot of flexibility to create that puzzle. These were two brooches that Benjamin gave me. They ended up not working, but it is a nice option to fill in a lot more space all at once. Now these curved pieces, which I really love, I decided to face outward all along the outer edge because it created a really beautiful scalloped detail. Again, like I said, I'm adding all the glue all at once and then I'm applying them all at once. And this is really helpful because sometimes the E6000 can like ooze. And so it makes it easier if you do sort of glue it once, then apply it once. Now, this trim is what I'm gonna use to go all the way around the collar. I'm starting off with the bottom part because this trim can't like turn on a sharp angle, so I have to cut it anyway. So I'm gonna start with that piece and let this all dry, and while it's drying, I'll move on to my shirt. Now, I bought this little like ruffle trim at Joann's, and I'm using a shirt I already own. This is just like an old Forever 21 white button down that I thought I'd actually wear with jeans with these crystal buttons. I thought it would be really cute. So this is what I'm using. Now, the top three buttons of the shirt I do need in order to get into the shirt, so I can't close them up. So I'm only applying my fabric glue in between the buttonholes. That way those buttons are still active. The bottom ones though, I don't need, I never unbutton them, it's irrelevant, so I'm just covering it entirely. Now I'm gonna take the ruffle trim and lay it nice and gently all across the top, and then when it buttons, it's gonna cover both. I'm double checking to make sure that my buttonholes are visible, and they are. Now you can see I found a really great match for my buttons, and you just wanna evenly distribute them. You can either measure it with a measuring tape or you can count like ruffles, which is what I did. Like 1, 2, 3, it's on the fourth ruffle. 1, 2, 3, it's on the fourth ruffle. And just do that and then add your E6000. Remember, when you're doing fabric to fabric bonding, you'll use a fabric glue. When you're doing metal bonding, you need a gem glue like E6000 or gem tack. And we were really kind of getting there. If you look at hers, you can see that she's got a couple of really big pieces. I was trying to decide if I wanted to do that. I actually think the two pieces hanging off the collar are earrings. I tried to use these brooches again, but it like looked like a face. I don't know, it was looking weird to me and I was not feeling it. I grabbed a couple other pieces from the trim that I had cut. And again, I just didn't like it, so I left it as is. Now, all I need to do here is really just fill in all of the gaps. So I started cutting up the little pieces into even smaller pieces so that it really gave me a lot more flexibility to fill in those tiny little spaces that were too big for some of the larger pieces. Even this trim, which is what's going all the way around my collar, those are tiny little perfect squares that allowed me to fill in the space. Now, I was so bummed, you guys. I got a huge blob of glue right on my jacket. If something like this happens to you,
this is what I recommend doing. Take a little bit of like an acetone-based nail polish remover and a Q-tip. Start agitating the glue with the nail polish remover and then with your fingernail. Now the reason I like the fingernail is that it's not so sharp that it's gonna rip through your fabric, but it is sharp enough that it's gonna start to break down and break apart the glue. It'll start separating it from itself and get kind of like white, and you see it starts peeling off. You've gotta be really patient with this. It took me probably 10 minutes, but ultimately I did get all of it off. This guy was a big, thick blob that I let dry because I knew it would be easier to pull off if it was just like thick. Again, I used tweezers, pulled it all off, and then added a tiny bit of black fabric paint to hide that kind of chalky white residue, but you never notice it. Now, when you're adding this trim that's going all around the collar, the first like, 4 or 5 inches, which is the part that's on the front of your body, you can do laying flat like this. However, the curved part, which goes around your neck, needs to be done while it's curved. Otherwise, it's not gonna lay right. It's actually gonna be too tight and it'll pop if you do it flat. So either put it on a dress form or like, I don't know how you wanna do it, put it on a friend, something, but you do need to apply that when it's on the curve so that it actually lays right. Now, because I'm a crazy person and a perfectionist, I actually cut a tiny piece of metal to put in between these two so that it looked like this piece went in a sharp angle and just curved all the way around. Now, last thing, and this was just for fun, I grabbed an old pair of earrings that I had and I glued them with E6000 to one of the little curved pieces of trim, which I love so much. Now, I've got earrings that are gonna go with my jacket.
That's it. I can't wait. I'm gonna model this for you guys and show you how cool it is. I am in love with how it came out. I had planned on sewing the whole thing down. I don't need to. It's so strong. I like shook it. I was like giving it a go and it's good to go. So you guys can make this totally no sew if you wanna do the same thing. All right, you guys, thank you so much for being here. I will see you next Friday for another great DIY. Enjoy the fashion show.
Walking on fire, trying not to bend my feet. I'm tired of fighting, saying things we don't mean. You know I don't like it when you're packing your bag and turning your back, calling me a liar, calling me a liar. Trying not to let my feelings get to me. Sometimes I can't let them go. So now I got these voices. Now I got these voices in my head. But feeling like I'm all alone. You don't seem to want me, even though you told me so. And baby, I wonder if we should just go separate ways. We could start over, we could start over. Trying not to let my feelings get to me. Sometimes I can't let them go. So now I got these voices. Now I got these voices in my head.